Does it ever feel like everyone is speaking a foreign language? API, CRUD, SQL, SDK, CLI, it's a lot. Today, let's examine a key tool of web development that's its own acronym, a REST API. So what exactly is a REST API? Basically, it's a predefined plan for how to connect services that use the web. Let's break it down by looking at what REST stands for. Representational means that the data sent between services conforms to a basic data type, typically JSON or XML. These data types are easy to transfer and to read and enforce consistency. State means that each request must carry with it all the info needed to read and process that request. That means every time you reach out to a service, you have to include authentication, headers, or any other info within the request. The server doesn't store any context between requests. Finally, transfer. Data is transferred using standard HTTP methods: get, post, put, delete, etc. Let's see it in action. We'll start by getting a list of to-dos. By default, fetch in JavaScript uses the get HTTP method, so we don't have to specify the get method. We also don't have to send along any info or state, since the get method is used only to retrieve data from a server. Now let's add another to-do. This will require specifying a method, including key info, like special headers, and making sure that the data is JSON. Here I'm using the post method to submit data to a server. And finally, let's delete a to-do using this REST API. Here we'll need to provide this specific to-do, but this particular API lets us do that in the URL here. Your service will likely also require you to include authentication headers, like so. So what existed before the REST API? For that, we'll have to travel back to the 90s. And if you were building a web service, you'd be using SOAP, COBRA, or some other protocol and probably wishing you never learned about computers at your local library. For example, here's what a SOAP request looks like compared to a REST request. The larger payloads lead to more processing time and slower performance, especially in environments with high network latency. Every API build with the REST architecture is straightforward and built in the same way. They're also scalable. They can handle large volumes of data and traffic.